Previously, we looked at creating a paper mask. For part two, we'll actually use that paper mask to transfer this image onto this panel. However you decide to attach your stencil to whatever substrate you're working on, it's a very good idea to attach it in a way that you can replace it exactly where it was at some point in the future if you need it. This is something that I don't normally do, but for an example, right now I have this stencil attached by two pieces of tape only at the top. So that will allow me to spray paint through the mask, and then I can lift it up and tape it up against the backing board of my easel out of the way while I work on the actual artwork. If need be, I can drop it back down and have that stencil in the exact same place that I started with. In this case, because I'm using two separate stencils, this is not how I'm going to approach this. I'm going to start with the outline, and I'm going to line it up where I want it, using this corner as a guide, and then I'm going to lightly tape it on here. And because I'm using two stencils, I want to be able to put both sheets in the same place at a later time if I need to. So I'm going to take a little bit of paint and spray right around the corners up here, and that'll give me a good reference for where it needs to go. Make sure it's dry with a little bit of air. And if you want to get really technical, you can do the same thing on the bottom corners. And that'll work for my purposes. Now, if you don't have a backing board on your easel, you may have to find another alternative to use a stencil, but whatever you do, just make sure that you can replace it in the same place that you had it when you started. Here's another little trick. I'm going to start by just dusting a light coat in the very background of this painting, just to give myself the outline of the eagle's head. When we cut out this portion of the stencil, right now I don't have any way to attach it and let it hold itself up there. So I'm going to take a hole punch and just punch a few holes around the stencil. That's good enough. Those holes will allow me to stick a piece of tape over the hole, and that will hold it onto the board. So I will place it in the location it needs to be. And then I can go ahead and remove this portion of the mask. I kind of think I want to add just a little bit of a border around this, just to add a little bit more interest to the piece. So I'm going to take some 1/4-inch fine line vinyl tape and add just a 1/4-inch border around edge of this. I want to leave the eagle in front of the border. So I'll trim the tape. I'll add a little bit of tape around the border just to keep it clean, just in case we missed a small area. I think that'll work. Now obviously you can see the paper is trying to roll up, but you can use your hand or the X-Acto blade or any other tool you choose to hold this down while we spray just a very light shade of color around it. All I want to do is just barely define the outside edge of the eagle's head. The color I'm using is Createx Illustration Black. It's reduced with probably one part of black and three parts of the 4011 reducer. I've also added a little bit of transparent base just to thin it out even more to wash the color out. Again, I want to start very light from the beginning. We can darken it up gradually as we go. I also added just a drop or two of white and a little bit of scarlet red just to warm it up a little bit. Here's what the color looks like at this point. So from here, like I said, I just want to barely dust a little bit of color just around the outside, just enough to define the outline of this eagle's head. If you get some paint blow underneath your stencil, it's no big deal. And then you can lift the stencil just a little bit to see if you have what you were after. I think that's good. From this point, I'll remove this portion of the stencil, and you see I've got a faint outline of that eagle's head. So from here, I want to spray just a little bit of color using this stencil, and I've actually covered up my reference lines up here. So I'll cut some of this tape back. That's better. So I'm just going to line this up, those corners. And in a case where you're using multiple stencils, it pays off in the long run if you take your time when you're lining this up. Make sure you get it right the first time, because if it's off just a hair, you'll have to go in and repair that later. I think that looks good. Again, this is very, very, very light. This is just the roadmap to get us started for the actual painting process. So I'll hold this down. Begin spraying over all the open areas. Again, if you can't hold it down completely, it's not a huge deal at this point. We're going to be coming in with erasers and other tools, adding texture and removing paint later. This is just for roadmap. Give us an idea of where we need to be as we're starting. Some of these areas you can come in a little bit darker. For instance, I know that nose is going to be pretty dark, and I'm not going to have to do a whole lot of work to it. So I'll come in a little bit darker with that. Same thing with the eye. We know this is going to be pretty dark. Don't mind adding a little bit darker tone there. The rest of it, I just want just a hint, just an indication. So let's take a look. I think I can work with that. A couple things I'd like to point out. If you pay attention to all these dark areas that we painted in through the mask, when we cut these out, remember I said, it will create a pretty crisp, strong edge by cutting those areas out on the paper mask. But in the beak area, remember I said we would roll this area up in order to keep a softer transition. And there you really see the difference. It goes from a relatively dark to a very nice soft transition into this area that's going to be lighter on the beak in the end. So keep that in mind when you're making your stencils. And there you go, guys. That's the basics. That's how I transfer an image from a reference photo onto the substrate that I'm painting using a paper cut mask or a paper cut stencil, whichever you want to call it. It can be a very quick process or it can be a time-consuming process. It all comes down to how much detail you need as the artist to give you the reference points that you need when you actually begin painting whatever you're painting. I tend to keep it a little bit more simple most of the time. I just want a little bit here and there, and I generally just go for the very darkest darks and that gives me enough. But everybody's a little bit different. So if you haven't tried it, give it a shot. In the next video, we'll actually get into painting this eagle. So I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you guys next time.